Hello, Western Oregon sports fans, and welcome to this edition of Wolves Weekly. Joining me today, we have Coach Arne Ferguson before a very critical game down at Abilene Christian, a team that came into the year ranked number four, only have one loss in the season. Is that when they played? When they moved, they were up to number three, played number four, Northern Alabama. Right now they're sitting at number 11, but great challenge in front of you guys once again.
Yeah, Abilene Christian's probably individually one of the most athletic teams, if not the most athletic team we've ever faced. They have guys that can run throughout their offense and defense. Good-sized D linemen, real good-sized O linemen. But their skill positions, and especially their quarterback, are very, very good at what they do. The North Alabama game, which is at that time it was 3-4, it went back and forth throughout the game. It could have been anybody's game. So we know that Abilene Christian's one of the most talented teams we played, and we're just glad after the Grand Valley game to be able to have another opportunity to play a quality team like that.
Well, fantastic. And I guess we should talk to you just a little bit. What will be some of the keys, as you say, try to maybe neutralize that speed in the going down to Texas, which we know is always going to be a tough place to go?
Yeah, first of all, the travel is going to be adjustment. It's going to be very similar to Dixie as far as weather-wise, which is nice, a little bit more humid. So that's good for us to have that Dixie trip. The second thing is their defensive line moves very well. We have to establish a running game against a very physical front. And then our receivers need to have a big day. I mean, a big day in everything they do. The blocking, the receptions in between that 10 to 12-yard area. But also we need to get loose against some real fast DBs. So those are things that need to be key offensively. Defensively, their quarterback controls everything. The quarterback and running backs are very, very good. We have our hands full there, and we have to limit the big plays that they're both capable of doing. And that was really that's been Abilene's success. There's games where they'll throw it 60 times. So I guess an All-American quarterback that was an All-American last year, so that has an NFL arm. I mean, he flat out throws that ball, it's on a rope, and it's there fast. So definitely it's a challenge with both sides. But also I think our special teams will have to push that envelope with them as far as our punter and kicker, which we haven't used Kelly as much as we normally have at this point because our offense has been doing a nice job of getting red zone points. So, but I think that'll be critical in this game.
Well, talk to me a little bit about that. You guys have won three straight games in the GNAC, sitting at 3-0 in conference, 3-1 on the year. Now you guys kind of step out of conference. How do you feel about that one?
Well, anytime you can play a top opponent, you know, I really felt us playing Grand Valley helped Central at our place, being able to play those quality opponents and for our players to learn and get better. And we it's a big test. It's our biggest test to date. So we're really going to see how the outcome is, but we feel our players are better prepared because of the Grand Valley game and because of the Central Washington game.
Do you feel then that they have, you don't want to use this word, I know it's a sports cliche, but are you carrying a little bit of momentum into this game?
Yeah, there's nothing like winning in football. I mean, it makes things, honestly, the injuries go down once you win. The injuries goes up if you're not as successful. So it takes care of a lot of those little things. But this would really come down to the execution of both offense, defense, and special teams, and it's going to be a tight game.
And it really does feel like you guys have got a little crisper on both those ones. Your defense is flying around recently, and your offense is, like you said, not settling. As you mentioned, you haven't used Kelly that much, which is always a good thing. You guys are putting the 7 on the board instead of the 3.
Yep. And so we're excited to have that game down there, and we're just hoping that our kids play the best of their ability.
I just want to remind fans out there, yes, the Wolves will be in Texas this week, and we never want to look too far ahead on this, Arne, but we want to make sure we mention the Wolves' October Feast 3-pack that will be coming up. Mm-hmm. The Wolves will be at Abilene this week, and then they'll go to Central, but then the Wolves fans will have the opportunity to watch them at home for 3 straight weeks. It'll open up with Simon Fraser on October 15th, Humboldt State as part of homecoming on October 22nd, and then close out the season with Dixie State at home on the 29th. Mm-hmm. Those 3 games can be purchased for $38 for a package. You can see the number on the screen right here. So make sure to line up, get those tickets, and come out and support the Wolves. It's a great time, and there's been a lot of entertainment out there, both the scoring, the defense, some hard hitting. It's been a great game, that one we've had at home, and everybody's building up the intensity on the road. They also have the viewing party going on at Crush again this week, so make sure to get out there. Come join the other Wolves fans and come watch the game and support the Wolves, even when they're on the road. So everybody, I just want to say thank you for watching this edition of Wolves Weekly, and thank you for joining us, Arne.
Good. Thanks, Danny.